You might know Inset Faces from popular 3D programs. I want to show you how to use Inset Faces in Blender. To start, first select your model. Then you switch to edit mode. Additionally, you should be in polygon mode. Next, select a polygon, move your mouse a bit away from the selected polygon and press the right mouse button. From this position, select Inset Faces. A dotted line will be created from this position to the polygon. When you move the mouse towards the polygon, you are setting the size of the new polygon within the selected polygon. I cancel the command with a right click. You can also activate the same command directly from the face menu. Then you can precisely set the size of the new polygon from this point. I cancel the command again with a right click of the mouse. If you press Shift and Space, you will see all the commands from the toolbar right at the mouse position. Now select Inset Face from here. This is the same as if you had started the command from the toolbar. In this case, you will see a yellow circle for the tool. When you click on this circle, the dotted line begins from this spot, and from here you now set the size of the new polygon. After the command is executed, the last operation panel appears. Here we now have a few options. Boundary affects only open surfaces. Because the selected polygon, from which we created the inset, has adjacent polygons, the command has no effect. Let's take a surface with some subdivisions, select a row of polygons, and execute Inset Faces. With boundary enabled, an inset is created in the selected polygons. As soon as I deactivate it, the open edge of the inset is ignored. This function is useful when working with mirrored objects. In this model, I deleted one half of Suzanne and applied a mirror modifier. When I apply Inset Faces to a polygon at the outer edge of Suzanne, no additional polygon is created at this edge. As soon as boundary is activated, the open edge is taken into account for the new polygon and an additional polygon is created. This, however, would be disruptive for our mirrored model. For the offset even parameter, I have selected a few polygons on the plane. Offset even ensures that the edges of the new polygon are parallel to each other, leading to a uniform thickness. As soon as I deactivate it, depending on the geometry of the model, this can lead to a potentially unwanted result. I have two polygons, a big one and a small one. When I use Inset Face on them, they both get smaller by the same amount because offset relative is usually off. This changes how big they are compared to each other. But when I turn offset relative on, they both get smaller by the same percent. This means the big one gets a bit more smaller than the small one, but they keep the same size difference as before. When I apply Inset Face to the polygons around Suzanne's eye and edge rail is turned off, the new polygons are created based on the normals of each edge. This can lead to an irregular edge flow. However, when edge rail is activated, the edges are aligned correctly, making the result look better and neater. This is especially important for complex shapes like faces. Depth adds thickness to the newly created polygons, either in a positive or negative direction. Outset reverses the command and adds polygons outside, not inside, of the original polygon. Select Outer automatically chooses the newly created surface. When Individual is chosen, each polygon is inset separately, not together with the others. The Interpolate option in Blender takes into account extra details of the object, such as UV layout, vertex, or weight paints. Let's look at this using the UV layout as an example. When Interpolate is activated and you add more polygons with Inset Face, the UV layout automatically changes. Here, the effort is made to ensure that the texture is displayed with minimal distortion. But if you turn off Interpolate, the texture gets distorted because the UV layout doesn't adjust to the new shape. Directly after invoking the Inset Face command, we can control Depth, Outset, the Boundary, and Individual using shortcuts. All the shortcuts are displayed in the top bar. Suzanne is mirrored with the mirror modifier. Press I to apply Inset to each polygon individually. Pressing I again reverses this. Press B to deactivate boundary, considering the open edge and preventing the creation of an additional polygon on the open edge. Press O to activate outset, which adds an extra polygon to the outer surfaces. Press O again to deactivate it. Holding the control key allows for easy adjustment of the depth. We can read the thickness and depth values in the bar. Right-clicking cancels the process. Confirm everything with a left click, and then you can adjust the settings in the last operation panel as we've seen throughout. If you like this video and want to see more, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel.